John Henry swims better than anyone I know. He crawls like a catfish, blows bubbles like a swamp monster, but he doesn't swim in the town pool with me.
Read Aloud is an opportunity for students to hear how reading should be done. Those moments where I stop and think, that really sparks ideas in my students' head of how to do this independently. That's the whole point. Can they take what we're doing in Read Aloud and try this in their own book by themselves?
I love that thinking. Great job. Let's move on.
PS 249 is a very diverse school. So every classroom has a variety of culturally relevant books. One practice we have every day is read aloud. They listen to stories while the teacher is modeling skills and strategies, as good readers do.
Read aloud in our school is an opportunity for students to read texts that are above their grade level. And teachers will model think alouds that they want the kids to try on their own. We're hoping to push our readers in their reading skills.
So we're gonna dive into our read aloud today. You guys all have a copy in front of you.
I like read aloud because you don't do straight reading. You actually get to like pause and think about it.
As you know, when we're beginning a book.
So today I introduced Freedom Summer. It is a text we use in our historical fiction unit about the segregation period. We start out by posing our teaching point.
Today we're going to be focusing on how setting affects other story elements.
Setting is where the story takes place. It was 1964, and that affects people's life.
All right, let's start with our first page. John Henry Waddle is my best friend. His mama works for my mama. Wait a minute, I feel like that narrator's inside the story, so it must be first person.
Even on the first page, I want to do that think aloud work that the majority of the room is not going to do on their own. What are those deeper ideas we're seeing here? Why is the setting so important?
I feel like the fact that John Henry's mother works for Joe's mother might cause some big problems in their friendship. So let's move on to the next page. We shell butter beans, we sweep the front porch.
Whatever your teaching point is for that read aloud, that's when you want to stop and do this work. It won't be every page. You want to be strategic.
Then we run straight for Fiddler's Creek. So I want to think to myself, what story element is the setting affecting here? You're going to turn and talk to your partner.
Even though they are different, they still find their own solution to spend time together.
Because I get to listen in to all these turn and talks and get an informal assessment of what kids are thinking about these texts, how are they responding to this question.
All right, let's come back together. I heard some of my partnerships talking that the setting is contributing to the problem and the solution, because although they can't play at the town pool, do they have a cool creek to go play in? Totally. So I want you guys to open up your notebooks. And we're going to answer the question, how is the setting important to the story? You can say the setting is important because it affects, develops, creates, shows.
So the stop and jots are to do that final thinking work.
The setting was really important in this book because the white kid and the black kid couldn't do as much stuff together.
During 1960, people of color were not allowed to pull the ice cream shops or any other places, so Joe finds alternative ways to help.
I want the kids to see reading can be fun. I'm interested. If I'm not excited about it, who's going to be excited about it with me? You know, I'll have a kid that comes up to me after Freedom Summer and say, I want to learn more, and I love to see that. We want to spark kids' interest and love of reading.